difference between prolotherapy solutions, whether it's dextrose or PRP or whatnot, versus cortisone, you know, it's actually very vast. Cortisone, when injected, you know, into a joint or around a tendon or whatnot, you know, can successfully mask pain, you know, for several months at a time. However, what happens on a cellular level is it actually increases degeneration and prevents your body from laying new healthy tissue. If it's injected into a joint, it can actually accelerate the degeneration of cartilage. The other thing that happens is, you know, let's say you inject cortisone and you're just, you've gotten rid of your pain. Well, you're just masking it. You haven't gotten rid of the underlying condition that's causing that pain. So you may not feel anything when you go play tennis or, you know, lift heavy weights. But what's happening is you're not feeling the more injury that you're creating to that tissue. So you're continuing to injure that structure and degenerate it without even knowing it. Cortisone, you know, is one of those that, you know, patients may get a cortisone injection, they do great for 6 months, they get another one, they do great for three, they get another one, it doesn't work. And they'll say, oh, I built up a tolerance to it, or I've weaned off. Well, that's actually not the case. What happens is when you, you know, first inject cortisone into a tissue, even if it's degenerated, and then you continue to do all these exercises that further degenerate it, you get another cortisone shot. Why it's not lasting as long, or why it's not as effective the more you get, is because that tissue has gotten that much more degenerated that cortisone is just no longer effective on that amount of injury. Now, to flip side that, what prolotherapy does, it's a very different treatment process. We're actually doing injections into structures and into joints to stimulate repair, to make new cartilage, make new tendon cells, make new healthy ligaments, and the treatment process is different. You know, we actually like to see patients meet roughly every 4 to 6 weeks, although that can be tailored to the patient, where each time we're stimulating repair and working to make new, healthy, strong tissue. At the same time, as that tissue is getting stronger, we, you know, quote unquote, clear patients for more activity, where maybe in the beginning we have them be really conservative, and then as that tissue gets stronger, they can slowly start to get back to their sport.